Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. The time for talk is over as we are just mere moments away from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Eagles going up against the Patriots.
Well, Larry, we'll have to go a long way to match the excitement from Houston last year, but this crowd is ready to give it a shot as we welcome you into our EA Sports telecast of Super Bowl 52 from Minneapolis. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. I'm Brandon Gaughan. To my left is my good friend Charles Davis, and what a thrill to be here for the biggest one of them all, the Super Bowl. And it seems to get bigger every year. The lights get brighter, the cameras more numerous. I don't know, there's just so much that goes into this game. It's an honor to be here, isn't it?
It is an honor, and I can't wait to share this game with you. This is going to be a whole lot of fun. You're my partner, my best friend. I can't imagine being anywhere else but right here with you. And just think about it this way. You mentioned the magnitude. This is no longer just a game for America or even North America. This is worldwide. People watching from just about every country in the world. This is impressive.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and just about ready to roll. The eyes of the world upon us tonight as Super Bowl 52 from Minneapolis is underway. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Here comes the Eagles offense and their quarterback, Nick Foles. Not the guy that they were expecting them to lead them to the Super Bowl, but that's what he's done. It's kind of a surprise number one seed getting to the last game.
When you say a surprise number one seed, it just doesn't sound right, does it? Is number one supposed to get there? But you're exactly right. They were the underdog at home against Atlanta in their first playoff game. Underdog at home against Minnesota in their second playoff game. It must have been those dog masks that they started wearing to try and get a little respect for being underdogs, because they worked all the way to the Super Bowl.
Well, we've said it. They've been playing with a chip on their shoulder, and I'm sure that they will continue to do so. Now a play fake here on first down. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. Give him 30 yards there.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make this a second and 13.
Yeah, that was the safety that came through and made the play. But there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker. And we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. Second down, offense behind the sticks here. Second and 13. third and 13. And the big boys up front in the trenches. What do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now Foles. He's going to air one out. This is caught inside the 15. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A gain of 32 that time.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 5. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Well, he did everything but get him in the end zone there, but now they're set up. Golden opportunity, strong opening drive, and they're knocking on the door.
And the way that they did it, now look where they are on the field, all right? This is naturally set up for a running play, isn't it? But with his ability to throw the football, his accuracy on this drive, you might want to think about a pass play in this situation.
Interesting. Time to find out. Yeah, the defense definitely showing blitz here. Foles. And his throw is incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. And quickly, let's check out the New England defense.
Let's shine a little light on Devin McCourty. One of the top safeties in the game, even though he only had one interception in 2016. The analytics people say when you watch him on tape, he makes all the plays that you need. Plays what I call top-down defense. Keeps everything in front. In fact, his team was the only team in the NFL in 2016 not to give up a touchdown pass of 30 yards or more. This guy knows how to play the position well, patrol center field, and knows what he's doing out there.
There's Foles. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The target there, Mac Hollins. And it's third and short.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodge two pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've kind of run out of your running plays. Fire another one into the end zone.
Now, do you put it in your quarterback's hands again? That's the question here on third and goal. He'll drop to throw. Complete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. How about the defensive stand here from first and goal? Three straight incompletion.
Yeah, I think people are wondering why didn't they try and run it at least once in there. But once the first incompletion happened, it's almost like they were committed to throwing the ball from then on out.
Good. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So they come into enemy territory. Nice drive to start the game, but they probably wanted 6. They only got 3.
I agree with you totally. That's the expectation. When you get the ball and you start moving it and you're rolling, you think you're going to end up in the end zone. But they should be happy with the 3. A good way to get things going here in this game.
Now After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. So Tom Brady taking the field with the offense for New England. Brady going to be making his record 8th start in a Super Bowl.
Hard to believe that he's had 2 losses, because when you think of Tom Brady starting in Super Bowls, you think of wins and big wins. Those 2 losses, both to the New York Giants.
Trying to become the first team, New England, to repeat as champ since
the New England Patriots.
And Super Bowls 38 and 39. They go play action here on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target. And it's second down. Now let's give you a look here at the New England offense.
I think Deion Lewis has hit the NFL the exact right time for his running style. Not tall in stature, so he hides behind the offensive line a little bit. Jump cuts back there. The defenders can't find him and have a hard time getting him down. Can catch the ball out of the backfield and has that extra ability to return kicks, which also causes a lot of problems for the opposition.
Now a former 5th-round pick of the Eagles. This is Deion Lewis. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that, because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
Throw on second down toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. The wideout, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver, and it's third down. And the defense now for the Eagles.
I'm gonna take a good strong look at the veteran presence in the secondary that is Malcolm Jenkins. Starts at safety, plays cornerback when they go into their nickel sets. He can move inside and cover the slot receivers. He's also a guy who knows how to turn the football around when he picks it off. 3 interceptions in 2016, 2 of them returned for touchdowns.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. From the gun, it's Brady. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. Timmy Jernigan in there to drop it for a loss of 10. And it'll be 4th and long.
I think most quarterbacks would love to have the goal line actually extend up into the air and turn into a wall, and they can put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
Here's Ryan Allen now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. So a short drop, but he's able to get it out, and this is a good kick. And taken right at the 35. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Eagles will have it, taking over 1st and 10. And here now the offense heading back out there. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3-point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Here's a handoff to Ajayi to begin the drive. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. This is Ajayi. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
So on fourth down, here's the veteran left-footed punter Donnie Jones to kick it away. Back deep, Danny Amendola for New England. This one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. As possession changes hands here, I get to talk to you about the Super Bowl. It's New England and Philly, a repeat of Super Bowl 39, although that one was in Jacksonville. This one, of course, in Minneapolis.
Yeah, I think the only thing that really changes is the weather. But this one's in a dome, so I don't think that that's a real issue for them at all. But guess what? New England has the same coach and the same quarterback. That's a big advantage for the Patriots.
Meanwhile, for Philly, everything's new, including the quarterback and Nick Foles that they didn't think would be there right now.
And I'm not sure Nick Foles thought he would be there at that point. But remember, he's been to the Pro Bowl before, been to the playoffs as a starter in the NFL. He's got a chance to play a really big game.
And he finds Danny Amendola. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. He got 29 yards that time.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Brady now on first down. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, a 22.
Well, there it is, partner. Brady to Gronk, their first connection of the game.
You think those two often in sync?
I don't think there's any question about it. And look, we know Gronk has a whole lot of fun, but he's deadly serious about his football, as is Tom Brady. Two great competitors, two fantastic players.
throwing on first down is Brady. And that's complete to the right side. It's Allen. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. A gain of 6 there on first.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
4 yards remaining now on second down. Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. They give him about 4 on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be 3rd and about the length of the football. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They run. This is Lewis. And the penetration too strong. He won't make it back to the line of scrimmage.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, 5th in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
What they want to do each and every week is make a game plan based on their opponent, not so much their own personnel, and they try to attack that way.
So on 4th down, Brady will yield to Gostkowski for the field goal try. This will be, 38 yards out. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and that will tie us at 3-3. So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with 3.
And that should be the goal for an offense, finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. That's complete to Jeffrey. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. On play action, they'll throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. James Harrison coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. Good for 5. It's 3rd down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. It'll be a gain of four, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. 3-3 our score. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. Here's Donnie Jones now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Dances by him. It's a 40-yard punt, 6 yards on the return, and the Pats will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field, and last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. They'll start things on first down with Deion Lewis. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Fake the handoff. Now Brady. Amendola catching it left side. And he's brought down after a good game. He got 29 yards that time.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there?
Yeah.
Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
Gives this one to Lewis. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Try again with Lewis. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. And the Eagles will go with an extra DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20. 20.
From midfield, here's Brady. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Brady to Gronkowski, they make it look easy, don't they? It's a Patriot first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
Down at about the 42. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else he'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
On second down, here's Brady. Quickly to Gronkowski, that's caught. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Brady to Gronkowski, cover athlete to cover athlete for a Patriot first down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
First carry down for Rex Burkhead. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. Well, he's not the starter coming in, getting his first carry off the bench. That's not the way to earn more carries.
You have to stay in the game, even if you're not on the field, right? Stay mentally sharp, stay ready. And above all, when you get into the game, hold on to the football. Don't let the other team have it.
The Eagles offense back out onto the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Fake. They'll look to throw. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time. And that'll bring up second down. Well, taking a step back, and we look league-wide for a second. On Tuesday the 16th, Pro Football Writers Association named the all-rookie team. Who was on the ledger?
Well, let's start with the headliners. Let's start with the offensive rookie of the year, Alvin Kamara, running back from Tennessee, third rounder with the New Orleans Saints. And Marshawn Lattimore, their first pick in the first round this past season, a cornerback out of Ohio State, the defensive rookie of the year.
Yeah, and Kamara shared that offensive honor with Kareem Hunt. What a year he had.
I mean, when you put it all together, at one point you thought Kareem Hunt was just running away with this thing. Remember, they got off to a 5-0 start, and he was essentially setting rookie records every week he played. And then Kamara and the Saints, with a late rush, made it a tie. Both of them well-deserving.
The Eagles on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. Here it's third and two. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
So after the defense gets you the ball on a takeaway and a fumble recovery of their own, you've got to reward them, don't you? You've got to stay out on the field, give them a chance to rest, and how about doing it the way they did it, running the football and picking it up on third down.
Would not have wanted to go three and out. They avoid that right there.
Yeah, they avoided the glares as they went back to the bench, didn't they?
Looking deep for his tight end, Ertz. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two, because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
They'll set up a throw. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Ajayi finding room to the 20, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Jay Ajayi, 31 yards, and the Eagles are able to cash it in for six.
Well, pardon me, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. So that drives seven plays in length. And it's capped off by a touchdown run by Jay Ajayi. Now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. Oh, good move. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. You can count his carries on one finger. They've only given him the rock one time, Charles. What gives?
So we can't draw any conclusions just yet. He has to touch the ball multiple times in order to get into a rhythm and have a chance to have success. You know who else gets into a rhythm? The offensive line. They feel better about what they're doing when they know they've had multiple opportunities to get it done.
Yeah, well, the conclusion we draw so far, they're losing here in the second quarter. Let's see if they change tunes.
Hey, Alabama,
start off with a give to Lewis. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Now Brady throwing on second down. Got a man complete. It's Chris Hogan. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Now Lewis. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Play fake for Burkhead. Now Brady. So tough to stop Gronk. Oh, he's able to outmuscle him here as he pulls it in. The familiar refrain, Brady to Gronk for the New England first. Remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Super Bowl 52 after this. A reminder, coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Brady now on first down. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Timmy Jernigan in there to get him. His second sack now of the afternoon. On play action. Now Brady. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here. He throws it away. And now it's third.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. New England on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and a mile. They'll run it here. This is James White. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. Now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. Here's Ryan Allen now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. A chance for us now to discuss Jay Ajayi. He'll be looking to get in the end zone again. Had the touchdown, as you see, last drive on four carries. And during the break, we were looking at some of the replays from the previous drive. Really good holes created, great space.
Yeah, I like the observation you had, though, during that break about, okay, they've got to do something to slow down their runners. So is it bringing in more defensive linemen? Is it dropping in extra linebackers? What are you going to do? Personally, I'm going to take my safety and drop him into the box. I'm going to have at least seven in there until he shows that he can beat me through the air. Yeah. I've got to slow down the running.
I was just going to say, you'll take the exposure in the passing game over the top until you can prove that you can stop the running game.
Sometimes you go cold because you haven't thrown it in a while. Let's see if he can heat up again.
A good pick up there on 20 yards.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
To midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. So the offense takes the timeout and they are back out and ready to rock. See if they stay on the ground for second down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. This complete left side to Aguilar. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Drops it off to Ajayi. It's a gain of five, and it'll be a second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Here's Foles. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. Torrey Smith, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach, and incomplete. The Eagles on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and five. Now Foles. Now a hit, and Foles loses the football. It's out. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. Here's Donnie Jones now, as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. So we've come upon halftime in the big one, the Super Bowl. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Okay, Brandon, thanks. And welcome, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get to the highlights. The Patriots' offense has been on the field more, but it hasn't led to a big lead. The Eagles are competing hard, and it's still very much in doubt which side will walk away with the Lombardi Trophy. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Midway through the second quarter, ball's going to be up for grabs here. Now after the fumble, Ajayi is going to stay inside after the handoff, and he caps off the six-play drive with the score as they take the lead 7-3. Now first and 10, Jernigan's going to push his way to the QB here. This ends up as a huge loss in yardage.
Thank you, LR. Appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And, you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended?
In a punt.
Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
And this one maybe not quite that bad, but still you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On first down, Brady. They find some open field here. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down. His way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Brady going to give this one to Burkhead. Takes this to the 45. Got a little space after that nice move. It's a five-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, That'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
New England on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. They're up against a third and one situation. Again, they run with Burkhead. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Throw with Brady. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over, that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Brady now to throw. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. Call it a gain of 3, and that'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to work his way down to the 16. It'll go as a gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a third and inches situation.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. The offense on third down tonight, 2 for 5 to this point. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. They'll run now with Burkhead. A 3-yard gain and enough for the first down.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage just come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Now Brady leaves to Burkhead on the draw. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 3rd and 1.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
New England on 3rd down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Brady going to try and throw on 3rd down. And this is going to be incomplete.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
And Gostkowski's kick is good. And that'll bring him back within four. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
Gostkowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here's Nick Foles as he heads back out to work. And yeah, maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. Hey, he's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. Begin the drive with a giant. And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, add that play to his resume reel, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
He'll look to throw. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and, of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Ooh, I like it.
So the offense has it first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got it across midfield and down to about the 47-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and 1.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Big loss here as he's taken down. Kyle Van Noy in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
The Eagles on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be a tough 3rd and 18. They'll set up to throw. And that is incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. Able to slither by. It's a 47-yard punt, return of 6. And the Patriots take over. All right, let's discuss Deion Lewis as he gets set to go again. And as the numbers show, he really wasn't in the mix at the beginning, but they've got him in the rotation now, and it's proved a good move.
And that's what happens when you're a good player. There's a lot more attention drawn to you. And it's obvious that they had him in their game plan on defense, not letting him get off to a good start, but he's found a way so far here in the second half.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On 1st and 10, here's Brady. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 13. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that. A little swing pass out to the right side before lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
Throw on 2nd down. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for 3rd down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
On 3rd down, that's Lewis, and he gets it to the 32, good enough for a 1st down. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. Set of downs here, and on the outside they're playing press coverage. Brady now on 1st down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. Nothing on that one. It'll be 2nd down. They tried to swing it out left into the flat, but the defense, they were very principled there.
It felt very West Coast offense, didn't it? You know their expression, right? On a West Coast offense, when they throw the ball, it's either going to be a touchdown or a check down, meaning they like to press it downfield. If they don't have it, swing it out, which is exactly what we saw there. But how about the great pursuit and tackle to make a nice play?
Throw on 2nd down. Brady going underneath for Lewis. And he will be hit with a lot of force and spun down. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it 3rd down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
New England on 3rd down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This is 3rd and 4.
Maybe 20. Maybe 20. Like we get.
Shotgun now for Brady. And a dump off to White. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. It's a gain of 4, and it gets him the first.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. It's Burkhead, and very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44. One quarter remains in Super Bowl 52. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Wide open, Gronkowski. And he's brought down. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
First down is Brady. It's caught left side by Cooks. And he's going to go out of bounds. He takes this one down shy of the 20. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs. In this case, the feet did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Now a play fake here on first down. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 6 on the play, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They'll look to make it 3 for 3 on third down conversions. They need a yard here. From the gun, it's Brady. This is caught. It's Cooks. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Brandon Cooks, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Patriots have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a three-point lead. So that drive, 12 plays in length, and it ends with a New England touchdown. Koski now out to kick it away. This is taken at the three. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Try and start this drive in the air. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Lawrence Guy in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about eight.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
To Ajayi, and they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. Ball at a gain of three, and it'll bring up fourth down.
But once again, a good example of situational football. That was third and very long, so you know they were guarding against the pass. And when they decided to run the ball, that was okay. Whatever yardage they picked up, as long as they didn't get to the first down marker, the defense was willing to concede, and they stopped them well short of a first down.
Here's Donnie Jones now, as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. A good kick, 48 yards, four on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Well, the Patriots gearing up to go now. And they had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They start the drive on the ground with Lewis. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, That looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
And now running right through it. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's 3rd and 2 now.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation, and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. New England on 3rd down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. And he's going to have a 1st down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. That'll be a New England 1st down, a gain of 12. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Brady now on 1st down. Toward the sideline, that's taken in by Allen. Give him a couple on the catch at 2nd and 8.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. There just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
To go here on 2nd down. From the gun, Brady. Allen's got it over the middle. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
The offense on 3rd down tonight, they've converted 7 times and could use another right now. They're looking at 3rd and a few inches. A play fake for Burkhead. Now Brady. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key 3rd down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word, put it in bold. Here we go. And able to find Dorsett. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Deion Lewis taking it in from 11 yards out, and the Patriots add 6 to their lead.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away. I think one of my kids just graduated in the amount of time they had the football. That was absolutely impressive.
Everybody wants those salt away the game drives. What makes them successful?
Well, when you're able to mix run pass, when you're able to control the football and stay ahead of the chains, I'm using every cliche I know, but that's how you get it done, because you're not taking negative plays, and that way you're able to run what you want to run when you get a chance to call it.
And his guys will take a 10-point lead. A 10-play drive that time, and it ends with a Deion Lewis touchdown run. Koski now out to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because 3 straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
Here's Foles. To the right side, caught by Salek. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now Foles, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
The Eagles on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. Here it's 3rd and 3. Foles. And that is incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on 4th down.
Yeah.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And he connects with Ertz. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. He'll look to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. They'll run it now out of the gun, and he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as he'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. The Eagles on third down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This is third and 9. They'll set up a throw. Now a desperation throw deep. He's got it at the 15. And he's going to be taken down deep into Patriot territory. A big play there for the Eagles on third down. 42 yards. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll bring up second down. They'll drop to throw. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
They're going to look to throw. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
Yeah,
you know.
Doesn't
you kinda
feel right.
Exactly.
It's up and good, and the lead's now down to 3 at 20-17. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. So with just under 40 seconds to go, you figure this is going to need to bounce their way if they have any shot. And this is going to be recovered by the hand seam. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. That is likely the final play of this game, and no better feeling, I would imagine, than taking a knee to wrap up the Super Bowl.
Culminates everything. The championship is theirs. And just think, the last play they had in practice before this game began was doing this, practicing taking a knee and winning a Super Bowl.
And they get to do just that. And it's another Super Bowl title for the New England Patriots. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
They are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.